And I just wanted to say that I'm here for you, Steve.
Yeah, I know you're here for me, Tracy. That's part of the reason why she's gone.
I'm on your side, Steve. I always have been. Because despite what you think, I am a human being, you know. Becky's away, he's single, he's highly vulnerable. I need to strike while
the key, she's hot.
Look, if I leave it much longer, Becky might just come to her senses, seriously.
Steve is missing Becky tremendously, and he's like a little puppy dog, he doesn't know what to do. He's getting on with Tracy okay. He's getting on with Tracy all right. She's actually been quite reasonable and a bit of a shock. But Steve's kind of playing along with it all for Amy's sake.
Fancy spending the day with us?
I can't, I'm behind the bar.
Oh, we'll get Tina in.
She's in tonight.
Amy would have loved that, wouldn't you, Amy?
Yeah.
Well, I'd have loved it too, but a man's got to work.
Tracy feels very positive about Steve because he's really fallen out with Becky. She's been determined to get him since she went into prison. You know, that's all she's thought about is Steve every single day. And she does genuinely love Steve.
Who's Clarky?
Oh, it's a new fella.
What? Did she meet him out there?
No, they went together, whirlwind romance. They say she's head over heels.
Tracy finds out from Sylvia in the cafe that Becky's away with a new boyfriend, Clarky, and they've basically spent the whole week in bed. So Tracy can't wait to tell Steve this.
She's having a great time over there.
Over where?
Creek? Oh, sorry, didn't you know?
He's very jealous, very brokenhearted, and she says, well, look, why don't you come round and have a meal? It'll be nice. So he's like, oh, OK. So he goes round.
Right, love, we'll get off. Good luck. Oh, it's like a big wiggly worm.
He goes, and there's a huge spread for like 50,000 people, so he's like, hello. And then he kind of wants to go, well, he does want to go home, and he puts Amy to bed. And then he comes downstairs and she's all kind of foxed up. Foxy.
You going out on the pool?
No, I'm in on the pool.
And he's like, aye, I don't know what's going on here. And he does one.
I turn into the person I want to be when I'm with you.
I can't. Sorry.
Well, he walks out on Tracy's post-meal courtship ritual and bumps into Becky, and he's all like, oh, hello, how are you? And she's like...
Big test in your relationship, going all together. Pass with flying colours.
Why are you doing this?
What?
Give me all the gory details of your fantastic holiday with your fantastic new fella. Are you trying to make me jealous?
After he sees Becky, he goes back to the Barlows and literally just grabs hold of Tracy, snogs her face off, and things happen.
Did you get some?
Yeah. This.
Becky does find out that Tracy and Steve have slept together, so there'll be a lot of fireworks on that one.
Dad came for a sleepover last night.
Did he?
Duh, except he didn't tell me.
He's really put his foot in it this time, really badly. What he'll do next is anybody's guess. And you can write in with suggestions to this address.